All right, so let's say we want to make a really simple web page that's just got a button that allows the user to connect to an Ethereum-compatible wallet like Metamask, and then once they are connected, then some content shows up, content that they wouldn't otherwise have been able to see unless they had first connected to their wallet. So it's like signing in, but not signing in through Google, but in a very Web3 way, signing in through their browser extension wallet. Kind of exciting. It also shows them their wallet address that they are logged in with. So this is the start of developing with Web3. It's not particularly fancy. It's a really simple video today, and we're just using the front end. So if you're going to actually do a full Web3 app that involves financial transactions and things like that, you definitely want to set up the back end as well. But today, just as a simple version in the front end, connecting a user through their wallet so that we can show them some content only if they've logged in through MetaMask or something similar. So to do this, we're just going to make a really simple HTML page, and we're going to connect it to the Ethers library, which allows us to connect to the Ethereum blockchain. So I'm just searching for Ethers CDN, and if I click on the first thing that comes up, this CDN.js, this Ethers library, I've got a link here. I can just copy the script tag for that. You'll notice that we're in version 6. And then I can just pop that into my web page. And as simple as that, I'm now allowing myself to connect to the Ethereum blockchain through this Ethers library, just with some HTML and JavaScript code. So perfect. You'll notice that I'm on version 6 here. So the code that I'm going to write is for version 6 of the Ethers library. If you're using version 5, the code will need to be very slightly different. Just make sure it's version 6. So to start with, I'm just going to write some HTML, and we'll keep it as simple as possible. Just a heading that says what we're doing, and then a button so that they can connect to their wallet. Connect wallet. And then a div, and this div is going to be where all the secret content is. So they won't see this div unless they've actually connected through their Ethereum compatible wallet. And in that, we'll just put a heading saying this is the protected content that they have private access to now. And we'll also, I'll just put an empty paragraph in there, and that's where we're going to inject in the message saying what their address is so they can verify that, yes, that is the address I expected I was logged in as. And then another paragraph that just says this content is only viewable if you've signed in with your wallet or something like that. With your wallet, just to let them know where it's at. Great, so as simple as that, we'll keep the HTML real nice and simple, and then we can write some JavaScript that works with the HTML and works with the Ethereum blockchain. So firstly, let's just give some IDs in our HTML. So this button, inside the opening tag of this button element, I'm just going to give it an ID, saying I'll just call it connect button or something like that as its ID. The div, I'm going to call that protected content. And then this paragraph I want to use later as well. So inside that opening tag of the paragraph, I'll give that an ID. I'm just going to call this user message, because it's something I just want to communicate to the user about what wallet address they're logged in as. So in my JavaScript, to begin with, let's just make some variables that relate to these IDs. So firstly, my connect button there, let's just go to the document, the HTML document, and get the element by its ID, which in this case is the connect button ID. So just pop that in there. So then I've got a variable I can use with my JavaScript later. And I'm just going to do the same for the other two variables. Okay, so now that I've got all my variables set up, I can actually do something with them. Okay, and the first thing that I want to do is hide that protected content. So I'm going to take my protected content variable, which refers to that div with the secret content in it, and I'm going to say .style, referring to the CSS, and the display, I'm just going to say equals none. In other words, let's get rid of it, let's hide it, let's not make it viewable to the users when the page loads. Okay, once I've done that, I also want to do something with my button. So my connect button, it needs to actually be active, it needs to work. So I'm going to add an event listener to it. And the event, of course, that I'm waiting for is a click. if the user clicks on that connect button, then I want a function to run. I'm just going to call the function login. Of course, it could be called anything. I'm just going to call it login today. And then I need to actually create this login function. This is the JavaScript where it actually happens. It's an asynchronous function. And the function is called login. And we'll just set it up the same way we would any other JavaScript function. Okay, so then we're going to start with an if statement in this function. So if some condition is true, then we will run some code. And that condition that we're waiting to be true or not is, do they actually have an Ethereum-compatible browser wallet? And if they don't, I'm going to have an else statement here that catches that. And I'm just going to give them an alert saying, I'll use Metamask because that's probably the one that we're talking about. Metamask is not installed. Please install it, or something like that. Please install it. So that's it. Hopefully that would be the reason that they don't have that wallet installed in their browser, that this code is not working. But if they do have a wallet installed, then that's the condition that we're putting inside the condition of our if statement. And we'll do that by saying type of, and then window dot ethers, because we are using the library, the ethers library. So if there's not that in their browser window, then it won't say undefined. It's kind of like a double negative here, but undefined. So if it's true that their window is not undefined for the wallet, then it means that there's a wallet there and we can carry on and write our code. If it is undefined, in other words, if this is not true, then it means they don't have a wallet, and so we'll come back to this alert saying please install an Ethereum compatible wallet of some sort. Okay, but assuming that they do have a wallet in their browser, let's actually write the code for that. So the first thing to do is to actually, we're going to create this provider variable. Provider equals, and then we're just going to create a new instance of actually enabling this wallet. So new, we're going to use, again, it's the ethers library, not Web3 at this point, we're using ethers. And I'm going to say browser provider, and that actually opens it up to not just MetaMask. So a new instance of whatever browser provider they're using. And then we're on the Ethereum blockchain, window.ethereum. Okay, so that's just going to be stored in our provider variable, but allowing them to create a new instance of this browser provider, MetaMask or whatever it is. Okay, so obviously everything is asynchronous here as well. So we're going to set up a try catch block next. So we'll try some code, and if it doesn't work, we'll hopefully catch the error. And if there is an error, we're just going to log the error or console the error. There is an error. Just leave it at that for now. Obviously we can do this better, but you know, and then we'll just say what the error is. Hopefully that doesn't happen. Okay, so that's what happens if there is an error. But if there isn't, they do have a Ethereum compatible browser wallet, then this is what we're going to do. We're going to await the provider and send, and I'm just going to use eth request accounts. So all this is doing, I'm just going to I'm just going to put an empty array in here. So this is probably the most important line of code in the whole thing, which is basically allowing us to connect to that wallet. So we've got our provider variable here, which is making a new instance of it through ethers. And we're just saying, please give us this account. So it's allowing us to connect to the user's account. In the front end, whatever account is there on their wallet, it's allowing us to connect to that. And if that works, then we're kind of done. It means that we can do what we promised we'd do, which is to show them that protected content. So let's say protected content.style dot display equals block, and that all happens if they're actually able to connect to their account. So they connect their account through their Ethereum-compatible wallet, and then we can show them the secret content. Easy as that. However, I want to take it one step further and just allow the user to see the wallet address, the public wallet address that they've signed in with, just to verify that that's what they expected. So in order to do that, I'm just going to make a variable here called signer. And that is just going to equal, I'm going to say await, because I just need to, it's asynchronous, await. And then we're going to use that provider variable that we used before. And then I'm going to use the getSigner method from the ethers library. So that allows us just to find out some information about the person whose account has actually connected to our web page. And then with that information, I want to update my user message, which in that variable I made refers, of course, to this empty paragraph that I was in my HTML. So I want to use that and actually put something in there, put something into the HTML. And what I want to put in is both some text, a text string, and the information that we're getting from the Ethereum blockchain about their public address. So because I'm putting both those things in, I need to use the back tick. So that's not a quote mark, that's a back tick. So I can combine the text, which I'll say you have logged in with the address. And then I'm going to use my dollar sign and fancy brackets to put in, just to grab that address. So again, it's asynchronous, so I'm just going to say await. And I'm going to use that signer variable that I made before, signer dot. And this time I'm going to use the get address method from the ethers library. Simple as that. I do just need to close off that block with the back tick there. So back tick at the end and at the start allows me to combine the string with this logic here of getting their address from the Ethereum blockchain. So I think we've done it. We've got the simple HTML and we've put some variables in there and we've hidden the protected content. But once they click the button, we've got our event listener that runs this function, which allows us to check that they have a browser extension wallet that's Ethereum compatible. And then it makes a new instance through ethers of that browser provider. And it gets information about their account and loads up that, or pops up the wallet where they can sort of confirm that they want to connect. And once they're connected, it'll show that protected content and it'll actually then show the address that they are signed in with. However, unfortunately, if I say that, it's not going to load just as simple as that when I click on, when I open up the index.html file, if I just load that up. Then I can see all the HTML, but if I click the wallet button, not only does nothing happen, but I get all these complaints in the console about it not sort of working. So the reason for that is I do actually need to serve it. I do need to run this on a local server. So real simple though, don't worry if you haven't done this before. Just go to your command prompt if you're on Windows, or a terminal if you're Mac. And then all you actually need to do is just navigate to where the file is. So mine is on my desktop, and then inside a folder called Web3, and it should be in there. Let's just check. There's my index.html. And then I can just run the server. So easiest thing for me to do, I'm on a Windows and I've got Node.js installed. So I can just do http-server and I can just run up a server like that. It really is that easy. Or if you're using VS Code, you could run a server that way, or you could do it through that, or a Python server. There's lots of different ways to do this that you can Google, but just run the server locally. In fact, if you've got GitHub, you can put this index.html on GitHub, and if you were to publish it through GitHub Pages, it would work as well. But it's not going to work just by opening the file locally. You do just need to have a server of some sort. So I'll just copy the address here, the local location for where it is. I'll just go to the browser now and pop that in. And now that should hopefully work. If I press connect wallet, it brings up my browser wallet, gives me a choice actually between different Ethereum compatible wallets. And if I click login with MetaMask, now I can see that protected content. And not only that, but it actually shows me the address as well. I can also, if I wanted to, I could swap accounts here and put it from one account to the other. And if I were to refresh the page and log in again on that new account, you can see now it's my new address, or the different address. So it's confirming for me that I have actually swapped accounts and now I'm signed in with a different public address. So, very simple, logging in with an Ethereum-compatible wallet. Obviously, we could change the CSS, make that look nicer, and you can have some fun doing all sorts of things with that. And that hopefully is a nice starting point for developing with Web3 and interacting with the blockchain with a website using Ethereum and JavaScript.